receive it. I receive it. I believe it. That I may be a doer of it. You increase and I decrease. Have your way, Father. I pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. The Lord is doing something corporately. He's indwelling his body corporately. He's been talking to us a lot about the one body, every member that he has need of, and we need one another. And after last Wednesday, our word was on the prayer of agreement between couples, between people, between members. And I don't know about you, but I felt like the Lord lifted us up because he is doing something with this agreement after the corporate fast that we have gone through. And he has said in this update that there was three different things. See, this is not good because it was working perfectly. Just saying. So in the name of Jesus, I take authority over every, whatever you call them, and I declare God's word will come forth in Jesus' name. So we've been having so many testimonies about what the Lord is doing in and through us, one body, the bride of Christ, what the Lord is doing in this season. And he said there was three things that he's bringing increase to, and I want to zoom in on those three things again. So if you want to look with me, turn to 2 Timothy chapter 1. And let's just start in verse 8. Those three things that I mentioned, but I didn't go to this passage that he's doing, is he taking us to a place that we are going to be convinced, we're going to be committed, and we're going to be consistent. And I want to bring it by the Spirit tonight because Father says that's the Wednesday night, people. Amen. So this is not a word to tell you what you should be, but it's a word to encourage you because you are that. All right. Did you hear that twist between religion and spirit? All right. So it says, therefore, do not be ashamed of the testimony of our Lord, nor of me, his prisoner, but share with me in the sufferings for the gospel according to the power of God, who has saved us and called us with a holy calling, not according to our works, but according to his own purpose and grace, which was given to us in Christ Jesus before time began, but has now been revealed by the appearing of our Savior Jesus Christ, who has abolished death and brought life and immortality to light through the gospel, to which I was appointed a preacher, an apostle, and a teacher of the Gentiles. And now in the next verses, we see those three things. He says, for this reason, I also suffer these things. Nevertheless, I am not ashamed, for I know whom I have believed, and I am persuaded, oh God, that he is able to keep what I have committed to him until that day. Hold fast the pattern of sound words which you have heard from me in faith and love which are in Christ Jesus. That good thing which was committed to you, keep by the Holy Ghost who dwells in us. That passage is so powerful. You know why? Because first of all, he said, I am not ashamed, even though he was going through a whole lot of things, because you will never be put to shame. Believing in what he has shown you that he has done through the cross. I'm going to take this one. It's okay. No, I'm serious. I know it's not you. They did the testing, the spiritual warfare. But we always have a backup plan, B, C. If there's no mic, we'll do it without a mic. Hey. Amen. The enemy is defeated. So the first thing that I mentioned to you is being convinced. And he said here that he was persuaded. He's not ashamed because he's persuaded of this thing that is so powerful. He says, for I know not what I believe, but he said, I know whom I have believed, and I am persuaded that he is able to keep, oh my God, what I have committed to him unto that day. And then the next verse, when he talks about that good thing which was committed to you, keep by the Holy Ghost which dwells in us, it's two different things happening here. It's the things that you commit to God after the things that God commits to you, but it's also what God commits to you after the things you commit to him. And he says that he's persuaded that when you really commit your life to him, when you are persuaded in the one that you believe, when you know that you believe in him, not just because of what he does, but just because of who he is, when you present your life a living sacrifice, you literally commit. That word literally means you make a deposit. You give yourself with trust. It really means to trust. You give your whole life to him. And it means that when you give yourself to him, he's able to keep you. And many times the focus is on the next commitment, that what he gives to you, you have to keep. But it says you keep it by the Holy Ghost. And it says that you do it by holding fast to the sound word, to every word that carries life in it. And oftentimes when we talk about every member matters and we all have a purpose to do, we all have our part, we focus on the part instead of the whole. Or we try to pay attention to others, but we can't pay attention to others unless we first see the whole picture. It would be like a husband and a wife. In order for them to be in agreement, to be one, they have to keep their eyes on the whole picture, on the marriage. What's best for our marriage, not what's best for you, not what's best for me. What's best for us? It's to have the eyes on the whole. He as an under shepherd, when I hear the heart of the Father, he always has his eyes on the whole thing. Then it helps you make decision on the part, especially if that part is yours. And in order for you to be able to commit whatever gift and be a good steward of what he has placed in you, each one of you. Stewardship is money, it's your talents, it's your time, it's everything that has been placed in you. And you know what I love about this whole passage is it shows you the whole. It says you can trust him. You can trust him to keep the whole thing that you give to him. You didn't give just one part of you. You presented yourself a living sacrifice. You gave your whole life to him. You gave your heart. And I don't know about you, but many times in my life when I was trying to make a commitment or to stay strong into what God had called me to do, I always had to go back to that first. I belong to you, and you are keeping me. I can't keep myself. You are keeping me. Each one of you, he's kept you through the storms, through the lack, through everything that you went through. He kept you because you belong to him. He preserved you. He kept you in a way that you will never fully understand how even now he's keeping you in the palm of his hand. Jesus said, no one will be able to snatch you out of my hands. Those that belong to me, they belong to me. You have got to know the whole, because your warfare is not carnal but mighty through God, and your warfare will always focus on a part of your life. It will always focus on a little part. And if you focus on that part, then you lose the pictures of the whole. Everything that you do as a member of the body affects everyone. There's no decision that you make in your life that's just for you. It affects the whole. It affects the testimony of the whole of the body of Christ. It affects other people, because when one hurt, we all hurt. If you think of your whole life that you gave, your whole life to him, it's a deposit, because you know that even who you gave to him is nothing. It's a deposit. Because your glorious body will even be glorious in ways that you cannot explain. It says that then when you have to commit in something, in anything, based on what he has put in your spirit, it says keep it by the Holy Ghost that dwells in you. Whoo, my God. So not only he keeps you, but he gives you the Holy Ghost to help you keep. There is no gospel like the gospel that we believe, that we preach. It's not the gospel that we remain the way we were, but it's the gospel that the moment that you commit your life and you give yourself unto him, he gives you another deposit, the deposit of the Holy Spirit, to help you keep on keeping on. You know, this is a generation that as God is lifting up and bringing forth really corporately the kingdom aligned with everything that he wants, that he's going by the Spirit, he's going to do something in each of us, and he's doing that especially in you. I call you guys the disciples, the guys, the ones that are so bound and determined to be consistent, never to go down, but to stay up. And you know, you've learned over the years, or over the month, or over the days, or maybe over the last hour, or maybe over the last 15 minutes, how you have to be persistent, and how you cannot be persistent without the Holy Spirit. Without the Holy Spirit, you cannot keep anything that he gives you. Everything that you will say, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that, eventually you will come short. Might not be today, but eventually one day you will come short. When I think of the story of the church that's open, many times here the church is open and there's nobody watching, I always know that it's not to be concerned, because he's keeping. He's keeping what has been committed unto him. Everything that's his, your God is
keeping. He's keeping his eyes on things from the beginning of the year to the end of the year. There is nothing that pertains to you that your God doesn't watch over. When he tells you that he wants you to increase your commitment, it's because he wants you to know, you can trust me, says the Lord. But I'm going to take you to a place by my Spirit that you're going to know that you can be trusted too. Because you represent me. You, my child. Everywhere you go, you represent me. I need people to know that they can trust me because they can trust you. I need you to be of such character of my Spirit that people will know that you are loyal, that you can be depended upon, that if you say you commit to take care of the children, that you take care of the children, that nobody has ever, I never have once, and I'm glad you're here tonight, I thank you. I never have once to wonder to come here on a Sunday morning and there's nobody to watch the kids. But there was a time that it happened, many times, that I would walk in and someone that was supposed to watch the kids wasn't here. Someone who was supposed to do something wasn't here to do it. Someone didn't come to empty the trash. Someone didn't come to clean up the bathroom. The floor wasn't vacuumed. Little things like this. And I remember saying, oh, Lord, I'll do anything you want me to do, but can you bring... can you bring people? And I said, Lord, bring those who can commit to what you have put in their heart. And it doesn't mean in God that you continue to do the same thing, but when you commit it unto him, when you give him the whole, then your focus is on the whole, not on whatever little part. Your focus, your dedication is unto the Lord. And that's what I see in you guys. I see you week after week being so faithful. Do you know that the word says that you do not lose heart because whatever you reap, in due time, whatever you sow, in due time, you will reap. He said, do not lose heart. He said, be persistent. How do you stay consistent? How do you stay day by day? How do you keep on keeping on? You keep on keeping on by keeping your eyes on the Lord. Because not only he keeps you, but he puts in your heart that it's not about what you do, but it's about who he is. I know people that have been so committed, dedicated for so many years to the kingdom. Not just, and I'm not talking to glory, you understand? Is anybody here? I'm talking to the kingdom. That what you did, whether it was the money you gave or the time you gave or the talent you gave, you didn't give it to anyone in the natural. You have to know that because it's going to be time to reap. You didn't sow it in the natural. You sowed it in the Spirit. You sowed it in the Spirit. The Holy Spirit, when he leads people to go to step up to the plate. You know, I remember one day he gave me this visual and I had this a ladder. And on top of the ladder, I put in a plate. And the ladder was that big. And I was showing how difficult it is to step up to the plate. Because when you step up to the plate in God, you don't really know what the plate looks like. You just know God is stretching you for more. That he sees the whole, but you don't always see the whole. And that you can grow weary in well-doing if you pay attention to your part. Not just the part that's working, but especially the part that you're still working on. I'm not this, and I didn't do that, and I don't have that part. The Lord, he wants to anoint us to be able to see the whole, not pay attention to all the little distractions that try to cut you off, so that whatever you do as unto the Lord. Because I believe that we ride on the verge of a great, 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 great outpouring of your God that's been keeping some things. He's been keeping some things. Make no mistakes, that God has a principle that He knows how to reward. He knows how to reward. God looks at faithfulness. And when I prayed for you today, that's what I saw. I said, Father, there's so many people that I know at Glory to Glory that have been faithful for years. Ever since they've been born again, they just have kept the faith. They kept running, even when things happened in different churches that they were. Instead of walking away from the church, they kept looking for the real church. They kept their eyes upon you. They kept believing, my God, you have kept them. I know so many people. You here tonight, and I know some other people. They have kept everything that the Lord has put in them by the power of the Holy Ghost. They didn't look on the outside, they looked on the inside. No matter what people did with their money, they kept giving because they were giving to God, not to man. No matter if nobody was giving them a pat on the back for doing something, they kept on doing it because they didn't do it to man, they did it for God. And they didn't do it to get something in exchange for God. They did it because they were a steward of what was already been given unto them. They did it because they committed themselves, and they knew that God was keeping them. God kept you. I know people that have walked away. And I'm talking again in general, since you've been born again. I know many people that have walked away. Hallelujah. Because the enemy will always bring things to cause people to walk away. But he's kept you. And it doesn't matter what you're doing right now. The fact is, you're a member of the body, and you being a good steward of whatever is as entrusted in your hands. You might not be perfect, but every day you persist. Every day you keep on keeping on. Every day you press through the things of the world, the things that the enemy brings your way. Every day. Why? Because you know whom you believe. You believe in Him. You know that He's keeping you. Even if no one around you keep their words, even if no one around you keep anything, your God is keeping you. You can trust Him. You can trust your God. And now, as He releasing an anointing so that we can be trusted. Oh, that the Lord may trust us. You know, that the Lord may trust us. What do people do when nobody else is looking at them? Or one day I asked the man of God, what do you think you would do if you could do something that nobody would know about, including God? Ouch. Because true character is what happens, not now when we're here, but when we go home. The true character is when nobody's looking. But you know what I love is, even when nobody else is looking, the Holy Ghost is watching. The Lord is there. He's there to keep us. He's there to watch over us. To me, that beautiful picture that God can keep us in everything that's going on is so beautiful, because when there's a deposit, there's more to come. You have the Holy Spirit in you as a deposit. Do you know that this is the season that the Lord is causing the church to arise? That everything that He has been put in you, all of us corporately, it's going to increase as He's taking us to fullness. It's not about what's going on today or what will happen tomorrow. It's always about Him, the whole. It's about the whole picture. And the whole picture, I see it in this season, that the Lord is going to show you what you've been waiting for. Peace, joy. Do you know how long you've been waiting and waiting and waiting? And pretty soon you're going to have a little job, and you're going to continue to study, and you're going to have joy. And do you know one day you're going to have a glorious body? The Lord is going to cause the Holy Spirit to do something in your life that you're going to be able to do by the Spirit, that you're going to be a steward of something by your Spirit. If somebody says to you, well, give me all your money and I'll keep it for you. And the person who tells you that, of course, it's the bank. The bank system. Put all your money in the bank. We'll keep it for you. We'll even insure it. you never have to be concerned. We're going to keep your money for you. Can you trust it? You can't trust it, can you? There's no way, right? Now think of everything you need to be a good steward of, and think about giving it to Jesus for Him to keep it. Now take all your money, and I'm talking in your heart. You're giving in everything, all your money, and you say, Lord, I committed myself to you. I belong to you. Everything that belongs to me belongs to you. You're keeping me and you're keeping my money, and I trust you that you're keeping my money, that nobody's going to steal the money that belongs to you. You're watching over my money. You're watching over everything, and I continue to give unto your kingdom. I'm putting treasures in heaven. I continue to know that my money belongs to you. Now, if you do that with your children, oftentimes there's people that do a paperwork, you know, that people say, well, you should do a paperwork because who's going to keep your children if something happens to you? Who would you like to be in charge? Who do you give power of attorney? Who's going to keep your children if something happened to you? And no matter what paper you do, you're not sure that the person you're leaving your children's going to be there when something happened to you? Can you trust it? No. You can trust it. But now your children, you give unto the Lord. You commit unto the Lord. Say, Father, my children, they're your children. And I remember that scripture, and your words say that I know that you are able to keep that which I commit unto you. My God, when you have anything to do that he's looking at you yielding to the Holy Spirit to be a good steward, to commit your gift unto Him, there is nothing that your Father is not able to bring your way, because He wants you to become like Him. He wants you to be able to keep He wants us, as he's bringing the whole body together, and there's going to be some situations of danger happening. There's going to be some things that we need one another, that we're going to need to have houses to hide people, houses to help people, whatever it is. Well, he's trying to get us to be like him. If suddenly I have to just say, hey, take care of that for me. I want to know that you take care of it just like it's your own, because we're part of the same body. The reason in the book of Acts everyone was sharing things is because they had a level of character. Now, of course, it's a different society that we are in, because we're not all one like they were one. But Father has is bringing us to a place that's greater than the book of Acts, greater than what we have seen, greater. He wants us to be so one, being able to help each other, that if one of you needs to have somebody stay over your house, you can trust them. It's, you know, let me say this, it's a sad reputation when Christians are not trusted. We have a reputation that people don't trust us. They think we're the ones that don't pay the bills, we're the worst tipper in restaurants. Now that's what, it's our testimony. We can't have nobody staying over because they'll steal our stuff. I remember the first time I had somebody from a church 20 years ago stayed in my house. I thought I could trust. I'm new in the church. I just get born again. I see a sister in need. Hey, you can come and stay in my house. Wow. Whoa. Okay. And in these end times, God's going to bring us like this. Like this. Like this. The Holy Spirit is gonna bring forth an incredible move that is going to take care of the character, and is gonna take care of us in a way that we're gonna be convinced, fully persuaded, we're gonna be committed, we're gonna be totally committed to Him. That if anybody tried to put a sign on whatever, of finances or whatever, somebody the other day said, well, Pastor, you're not scared? I said, well, what? What should I be afraid of? If God be for me, who can be against me? If the Lord is on my side, I will never fear what man can be unto me. And the thought was that they just had heard that somebody was going to just take over their money, their identity. They were going to put something on their fingers and a mark, and who knows? I said, no. I'm not looking at what the enemy is bringing. I'm looking at what the Word of God says He was going to do in this end time. I'm not looking at this. I don't see any doom and gloom happening. I know I'm not in the majority, but I see God raising up an army in this season that's going to be so powerful, an army that all together we're going to be able to speak forth His word. We're going to be able to see people being healed, set free. We're going to see revival, awakening. The glory of God is going to be spread. You know, in 2013, I had heard His glory will be seen in 13. And this morning, the Lord says, and He says, it was in 13 that I started, but now my glory is going to be increased in 15. My glory is going to be seen. It's going to be tangible. I'm going to keep my people. And we're going to be known by the way we walk in integrity. And we're going to be known by the way our Father is keeping us. Our Father's going to keep us. People are going to wonder, how come these people are making it? Because we belong to God. He's keeping us. He's taking care of us. He's keeping our finances. He's keeping our children. He's keeping our mind. He's keeping our peace. He's keeping everything that pertains. We commit everything unto Him. And He keeps it. When we get born again, you didn't give just part of you, did you? Did you give your whole heart to Him? Or did you just give a finger to Him? You just gave. He's keeping you. He's keeping you. You know how the Lord showed me He was keeping us? He's keeping us as close as He can. He's keeping us like Paul was telling Timothy, with faith and love. He's keeping us with so much love that if you ever have had your child be in danger or someone that you love, do you remember how you got? Whoever was in a situation that you thought, I'm just going to war for this person. And how you felt that you were becoming strong, weren't you? You were like, nobody's gonna take my children. Nobody's gonna hinder what I have. Yet even if you come close, you find yourself being strong. I don't know anybody stronger than God. I don't know anybody that can come against it. He's holding His body together as one, and He's keeping us together in this season. He's keeping every joint together as we're moving into fullness. So I'm asking you tonight, as I close, I want you in your heart, I want you to recommit all of you to Him. All of you, whatever that means to you, because sometimes you could commit one area but another. And tonight the Lord is reminding us, no, it's all of it. You commit your whole life. And then whatever I have given you to commit, then you do it by the Holy Spirit. Amen. I've even put some cards here with some pen if you want to put things in here. If you want to do a prophetic act, you can do it in your home. I believe there's, what do you call it when Elijah went, whoop? Whirlwind. There's whirlwind. There's been an increase of the glory in this place. And I believe He's doing something really special here at Glory to Glory. And whatever that He has put in your heart that the whole thing meant, I want you to recommit to Him tonight. Will you do that? Not to me, not to a church, but to the church, to the body of Christ. You've been so faithful, so faithful. How many have been faithful for years, waiting and standing? And all of you, all of you. All of you, lift up your hands. Say, Father, I commit unto You my whole being. I present myself a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto You. I believe in whom I believe. It's You. I am persuaded. Nothing can move me. In You I live and move and have my being. And tonight, by Your Spirit, help me be a good steward of everything You have given me. I surrender all, and I give You praise for what You have for us. We unite as one, that you may be glorified. In Jesus' name, amen.